welcome aboard. We are taking off from Los Angeles on a non-stop flight to Orlando. This was back in March. The air was clear and visibility was very impressive. Now infrared can penetrate to the haze and we'll be able to see mountains 500 miles away. Incredible, an epic flight with an infrared camera. Here's a map illustrating the flight path from Los Angeles. Along the flight path, we determine lines of bearing towards the mountains that I see in the distance. That's how I can tell what I'm seeing. Take special note of Humphrey's Peak. It's a great point of reference. If we were living on a globe, a sphere, the mountains in Colorado should not be visible. They're only 14,000 feet, and at that distance, the curvature would be hiding them. Flying at 30,000 feet, we should be looking down towards a tangential point to the sphere at about 3.1 degrees relative to our perceived horizon, or 90 degrees to the gravity vector. I was able to use in-flight theodolites to determine that that also is not correct, indicating the Earth is really flat. This graphic captures what I've learned so far from my infrared imaging from high altitude. The atmosphere prevents seeing at shallow angles. There's a critical angle beyond which the light rays just bend as they enter the warmer regions of the atmosphere with more moisture content. So we cannot see way in the distance. There is a limiting factor. As you can see in the inset, using my theodolite app, I determined where those angles were. And you can see that where the spherical Earth horizon, the theoretical, should be, we can obviously see above it. And at about 1.9 degrees, it seems like we can't see anymore because of the haze. But if we look at the surface that we're seeing, it doesn't curve out of view. If that were the horizon, it wouldn't look like that, you know? We would be looking at a zero grazing angle. As you watch the video, keep these images in mind. I've extracted what the mountains look like along those lines of bearing we saw on the map. So be on the lookout for these. I will try to narrate and point them out. Initially, I did not see the mountains at 500 miles. I thought they were clouds. I only noticed them around 480 miles when I was looking at Humphrey's Peak. That's when I noticed those pale, what looked to me like clouds. And then later I noticed what they were. Now here's the shocking conclusion, folks. We're seeing those mountains in the distance at the correct elevation for a flat Earth. Just incredible. Not only should we not be seeing those mountains if we lived on a sphere, but we're seeing them, and we're seeing them at the correct elevation for the shallow observational angles, which are about 0.38 degrees to those distant mountains and about 0.9 to Humphrey's Peak. Simply incredible. The Earth appears to be astonishingly flat. The flatness of the Earth has been known since the dawn of the space age. The V2 rockets captured from the German Nazis and brought to White Sands missile range gave our first glimpses of the wide expanse of the flat Earth. Incredible images. These rockets rose to about 65 miles above the surface. Just incredible. In my next presentation, I'm going to focus on the flat Earth phenomena from low Earth orbit. We're going to take a look at how images are composed from low Earth orbit and projected to appear like a globe make sure you subscribe, folks. We'll take a look at antenna radiation patterns and signal coverage on the surface, which illustrate the flatness of the Earth. Incredible stuff coming your way, folks. Then we'll focus on the celestial bodies and try to understand how far they are, what their path really is. Just incredible. The globe is at its end, folks. It is an archaic concept, the first approximation. Join the movement, ladies and gentlemen, because thousands, millions of people are joining the Flat Earth movement. Don't be left behind, folks. We are expanding our understanding of the world we live in. People from all over the world are conducting experiments. It is simply incredible. This channel has gone viral. Thousands of views, subscribers. Thank you so much to everyone. It is really not me and my monotonic voice that has made this popular. It is the content, the amazing discovery that our planet is flat. And those that know it have been keeping it quiet, not to awaken the masses. But the awakening has started. This is a sign of the end of times, folks. Really believe that. So join the movement and participate. Don't be left behind, folks. And now, let's get back to our awaiting aircraft and go on this epic flight. The first ever for me with a HD camera. And enjoy the views. You'll be seeing the world through infrared, 950 nanometer long pass infrared filter. Here we go, enjoy.
find more details about the menu in the back of Hemisphere's magazine or the Seatback Guide. We accept most major debit and credit cards. We now invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the service on Space Flight. Please let us know if there's anything we can do to make your flight more enjoyable.
jump off the flight deck. We're currently level at 31,000 feet, and right now it's smooth, so we're turning off the fasten seatbelt sign. Feel free to move about in the cabin, however, when in your seats. Please keep your seatbelts fastened just in case there's some unexpected bumpy air. Right now, we are 1,790 nautical miles away from Orlando, and we are expecting an on-time arrival today. Landing in approximately 3 hours and 49 minutes now at 5:48. Should exit the gate around 6 o'clock p.m. Last reported weather, scattered clouds, 74 degrees. Thank you very much for joining us today. We hope you enjoyed the rest of the flight, and we'll talk to you once again when we start our descent. gentlemen from the flight deck. Unfortunately, we're experiencing some light turbulence, so the fastened seatbelt sign just turned back on. Please remain seated with your seatbelts fastened. Thank you very much.
let's interrupt the footage right here for a second and do a flyout in Google Earth. It's an approximate location along the flight path. Actually, we had crossed Colorado River. But anyway, this works to illustrate just the curvature of the Earth that we should be seeing. Have a look at how it looks, how the land just appeared from that horizon. You can definitely tell there's curvature due to the aspect ratio, and also a little bit of curvature in the transverse or x-axis direction. Very interesting. I have to scroll here quite a bit to get out to the mountains. This is Navajo Nation land. Here we go. And now we're approaching the 14,000 foot mountains of Colorado. So keep that in mind as we continue with the infrared clips.